Hello friends, welcome to my channel Katha Manthan. Today I am going to tell you an ISE story, Crossing the Bar, written by Alfred Lord Tennyson. Summary of the poem. The poem Crossing the Bar propagates the idea of life after death, as happens to be the biblical faith also. Through the poem, the poet has tried to make the readers understand how he firmly believed in the theory of rebirth and how the soul, which is indestructible, passes away from one life to the other in hope of meeting the Eternal Father. The poem tries to epitomize the journey of the soul from this mortal body to the world of eternity, and in it he tries to establish that death is only a passage to the world of divine, going back to his original home from where he had come. This has been used as the central metaphor of the poem. Ironically speaking, this is also being regarded in the literary hierarchy as his epithet. He says in his poem that he would be pleased to leave this world of earthly belongings to go back to his original home, from where he had come, from upon the wishes of the Lord. He anticipates his death and believes that his passage from this life to the next would be smooth sailing. He says that he wants to be quiet and free from all anxieties at the time of his death. He believed that death is inevitable and thereby unavoidable. But he also believed the theory of indestructibility and immortality of the soul as being preached in the Bible. Therefore, he has carried the same notes in his poem Crossing the Bar, where he has tried to epitomize death as a blessing, death as inevitable, and death would happen only when being called by the Father. But death is the happy ending of a life. Is also portrayed as he says that he wishes to see the pilot at the end of journey. Here it must be noted that pilot refers to Jesus Christ, as is Christianity. Lord Jesus is regarded as the destiny creator and guide. Line by summary of the poem. Sunset and evening star and one clear call for me. इन लाइनों में हमारे कवि ये कह रहे हैं कि जब सूरज ढल गया और रात में तारे निकल आए, तब मुझे एक आवाज़ सुनाई देती है और वो आवाज़ मुझसे कहती है कि मुझे कोई बुला रहा है. एंड मे देयर बी नो मॉर्निंग ऑफ द बार व्हेन आई पुट आउट टू सी. इन लाइनों में हमारे कवि कह रहे हैं कि जब मैं नाव पे बैठूंगा अपना रास्ता नदी का पार करने के लिए, उस टाइम मैं कोई भी जगह से रोने धोने की आवाज़ नहीं सुनना चाहता. मैं नहीं चाहता कि कोई मेरे लिए दुखी हो या कोई मेरे लिए रोए, कोई मेरे लिए शोक मनाए. जब मैं सेल करने के लिए जा रहा हूँ, बट सच ए टाइड एज मूविंग सीम्स एज लिप टू फुल फॉर साउंड एंड फोम. जो हमारा कवि है वो कहता है कि ये समुंदर में बहुत सारी लहरें चल रही हैं, लेकिन लहरें बहुत शांत है. ऐसा लगता है जैसे कि लहरों में भी लहरें भी सो रही हैं, इतनी शांत है. और पूरा का पूरा समुद्र एक आवाज़ से भरा हुआ है, एक दुख भरी आवाज़ से. और सिर्फ पानी में झांक दिखाई दे रहा है, क्योंकि समुंदर का पानी में नमक होता है. तो वही कवि कह रहा है कि जब मैं ये नदी पार करने जा रहा हूँ, तो जो लहरें हैं उनकी आवाज़ भी काफ़ी सोई हुई है, और सिर्फ समुंदर में फोम यानी कि नमक पानी भरा हुआ है. When that which drew from above out the boundless deep turns again home. जैसा कि हम लोग सब जानते हैं, हम लोग को डीप, बहुत ही ज़्यादा डीप होता है समुद्र, और हम लोग को एक बार अपने घर दोबारा जाना ही होता है। इस लाइन में कवि कह रहा है कि जो इंसान का जन्म हुआ है उस इंसान को मृत्यु भी प्राप्त होती है, यानी कि जब जिस तरह से इंसान मिट्टी का बना है उसी तरह से इंसान मिट्टी में ही जाके मिल जाता है। ट्विलाइट एंड इवनिंग बेल एंड आफ्टर दैट द डार्क। हम लोग को ये पता है कि जब शाम हो जाती है तो चर्च में बेल बजते हैं, तो कवि इन लाइनों में कह रहा है कि जब रात हो गई है उस समय इवनिंग बेल यानी कि चर्च का बेल बज जा रहा है और उसके बाद सिर्फ और सिर्फ अंधेरा छा जाता है। एंड मे देयर बी नो सैडनेस और फेयरवेल व्हेन आई एम्बार्क। इन लाइनों में कवि दोबारा कह रहा है कि जब मैं सबको अलविदा कह रहा हूँगा तो मैं ये नहीं चाहता कि वो लोग शोक मनाएं, ताकि मैं शांति से अपना जर्नी अपने परमात्मा की तरफ ट्रैवल कर सकूं। फॉर दो फ्रॉम आउट अवर बॉर्नर ऑफ टाइम एंड प्लेस द फ्लड मे बेयर मी फार, आई होप टू सी माई पायलट फेस टू फेस व्हेन आई हैव क्रॉस द बार। यहाँ पे कवि कह रहा है कि हम लोग का जन्म हुआ है, उसके बाद हम लोग ने बहुत सारा टाइम इस प्लेस में यानी कि इस पृथ्वी पे गुजारा है, मगर हम लोग को एक ना एक दिन उनके पास जाना ही पड़ेगा जिन्होंने हम लोग को यहाँ पे भेजा है। यहाँ पे कवि कहता है कि जो समुद्र में फ्लड है यानी कि तेज पानी का धार, वो मेरे को बहा करके फिर से मेरे परमात्मा के पास जिन्होंने मुझे जन्म दिया है उसके पास ले जाएगा, और जब मैं अपनी जर्नी यानी कि मेरी यात्रा ये समुद्र से पार कर लूँ, मैं अपने पायलट को यानी कि गॉड जीसस क्राइस्ट को दोबारा देखना चाहता हूँ। यहाँ पे हमारे पोएट क्रिश्चियन है, इसलिए उन्होंने अपने गॉड यानी जीसस क्राइस्ट को कहा है कि वो उनको फेस टू फेस देखना चाहते हैं उनके सामने, व्हेन आई हैव क्रॉस द बार यानी कि जब वो अपना ट्रैवल ख़त्म कर ले। थीम ऑफ द पोएम। द पोएम क्रॉसिंग द बार प्रोपगेट्स द आइडिया ऑफ लाइफ आफ्टर डेथ एज हैपेंस टू बी द बिब्लिकल फेथ ऑल्सो। थ्रू द पोएम द पोएट हैज ट्राइड टू मेक द रीडर्स अंडरस्टैंड हाउ फाइनली ही बिलीव्ड इन द थ्योरी ऑफ रीबर्थ एंड हाउ द सोल विच इज इंडेस्ट्रक्टिबल पासिस अवे फ्रॉम वन लाइफ टू द अदर इन द होप ऑफ मीटिंग द एटर्नल फादर। The poem tries to epitomize the journey of the soul from this mortal body to the world of eternity, and in it he tries to establish that death is only a passage to the world of divine, going back to his original home from where he had come. This has been used as the central metaphor of the poem. Ironically speaking, this is also being regarded in the literary hierarchy as his epitaph. हमारी जो poem है Crossing the Bar, इस poem का theme ये कहना चाह रहे हैं कि हमारे poet को finally believe है, वो ये बहुत उनके अंदर ये बहुत विश्वास है कि इंसान अपना जन्म का और मृत्यु का साइकिल फॉलो करता है, यानी कि हर इंसान जन्म होने के बाद एक दिन मरता भी है और अपने फादर के पास यानी अपने भगवान के पास लौटता है। ये पोयम में कवि ने इसी बात को बताया है कि किस तरह से उन्होंने अपनी मृत्यु की जर्नी को ट्रैवल किया। लॉन्ग क्वेश्चंस एंड आंसर्स। Discuss Tennyson's Crossing the Bar as a poem of faith. What appeals you about this poem the most? Crossing the Bar is one of the best poems coming from the pen of Lord Tennyson. As the experts believe, Crossing the Bar deals with the passage of the soul from one life to the other. The root of the poem lays in the background of the scientific and technological advancement era. People of Tennyson's era believed in God and the powers of the Almighty. Religious texts propagated how God created this universe and how the land of man came into existence. But Charles Darwin, at this point of time, came up with his book called The Theory of Evolution, which gave a serious jolt to the belief and faith of the common mass. They were totally disillusioned about which one to believe. Confusion ran deep down their heart. They could not completely denounce the church which they have followed for ages, at the same time could not even ignore the scientific research propounded by Darwin. In this confusion, one thing was true, that is, their faith in the biblical version got a severe beating. Things which were practiced as a tradition and never been questioned before were now subject to several questions. Everybody started inquiring about the validity of the ritual and the proof behind it. The poet was no exception. He was also confused in this dilemma. He, being somebody of the Victorian era, had immense faith in the Lord. To him, the church would always be the epitome of truth, and anything coming from the church would be truth only. But with Darwin's theory of evolution coming into the forefront, he was also confused which one to accept as the supreme truth. On one side, there was the tradition to be believed, that is, the church and its age-old version. On the other hand, the modern scientific theory, based on data. He was bewildered at the beginning, but somehow overcame all the barriers in once again, establishing him as a fine believer of God as the supreme power and father of all creations. This poem is a true reflection of this standpoint of his. The poem Crossing the Bar propagates the idea of life after death, as happens to be the biblical faith also. Through the poem, the poet has tried to make the readers understand how he finally believed in the theory of rebirth and how the soul, which is indestructible, passes away from one life to the other in the hope of meeting the eternal Father. The poem tries to epitomize the journey of the soul from this mortal body to the world of eternity, and in it, he tries to establish that death is only a passage to the world of Divin, going back to his original home, from where he had come. This has been used as a central metaphor of the poem. Ironically speaking, that is also being regarded in the literary hierarchy as his epitaph. In the poem, the central subject lies in the passing of his soul from his material life to the world of eternity. He says in his poem that he would be pleased to leave this world of earthly belongings to go back to his original home, from where he had come from, upon the wishes of the Lord. He anticipates his death and believed that his passage from this life to the next would be something sailing. He says that he wants to go to be quiet and free from all anxieties at the time of his death. He believed that death is inevitable and thereby unavoidable. But he also believed the theory of indestructibility and immortality of the soul as being preached in the Bible. Therefore, he has carried the same notes in his poem Crossing the Bar, where he has tried to epitomize death as a blessing, death as inevitable, and death would happen only when being called by the Father. But death is the happy ending of the life, is also portrayed as he says that he wishes to see the pilot at the end of journey. Here it must be noted that pilot refers to Jesus Christ, as in Christianity, Lord Jesus is regarded as the destiny creator and guide. Thank you, friends. Thank you for watching my channel, Kathamanthan.